Hi, this is Mike Bale with Bangert. In today's session, we're going to talk about how we can use statistical accounts to do some project cost to complete forecasting in Sage Intacct. There are a few different ways you can do some forecasting in the system. One of the other methods would be to create a forecasting budget over in the project and use that in your reporting and financial reporting as well. In this session, we're going to focus specifically on using a statistical account to do that forecasting in the system. So quickly, we'll go in and take a look at kind of how that works behind the scenes, and then we'll get into actually doing a forecast. So inside General Ledger, you do have the ability to create statistical accounts. And in these statistical accounts, they can be either alphanumeric in your numbering system. So in this case, I'm using a demo database that already has some 9,000 series for statistical accounts. Some people would rather use a alpha type of coding. So for example, in this scenario, we're going to talk about cost to complete. We're going to have a PM go in and actually say, okay, we're going to put in what we think is remaining cost-wise comparative to our budget and our actual costs in the project. Another method could be cost at complete percentage, and then you could do a calculation. You know, you may want to label this account number as CTC, you know, cost to complete or something like that. But basically, it's pretty straightforward setting one up. Oops, excuse me about that. Didn't mean to click that. You know, you can come in and edit the account, and you can give it a name, let it know it's a statistical account. And then what you can do for reporting purposes is you can actually assign a particular account group for that. So what I've done is created an account group here called, actually labeled it with a project. So I actually called it Project Cost to Complete Account Group. And it's an account group that's based on a statistical account. And in this case, I just, you know, range one particular job in there. And then you can also label how it gets coded on the financial report as well. So once you have your cost to complete statistical account set up, it's really a matter of going in and entering some monthly projections based on that. And the way we set it up, it's based on the month. So what's really nice about that is you can have a transaction saved so you can see what it was for the current month. And you can also go back and say, what did I project last month? And, you know, what's going on here, why this change in between the periods as well. So what usually I would recommend doing is creating a particular statistical journal for that as well, just to kind of keep it in its own bucket. So I did also create a statistical journal here, and I labeled that estimated forecast to complete. It's going to be coded with a symbol of FTC. And then I could particularly just go in and look at transactional detail by all my entries just for my forecasting entries. So you can see here I did have one that was put in for May, and it will label it accordingly. But basically the idea is you can come into here and you can click add, and you can put in a posting date. So for the month of June, we're going to do our forecast. You can say, you know what, I'm going to do my projected cost to complete for 22-022, label it with a job as of June of 2023. You can put in comments here. You can put in attachments if you do have some backup what your projections were based on. And then you could literally just come into here and manually key in the information. Now, I'm going to also show you how you can import this information in as well. But in this scenario, I can just come into here and say, all right, for this project, for the Amazon warehouse, for this cost code. Now, this is only going to show you the list of cost codes that you have budgets for in the system. And you can come into here and say for coordination. Now, there's my statistical account, and I'm going to say I'm doing the cost to complete. And then you can elect at what level you want to do your projection at. In this sample, I'm just going to do it based on project and cost code. I don't want to have a projection for each cost type, but you could. You could say, here's my projection for labor. Here's my projection for materials, depending on which cost code you are on. So if you notice,
What you can also do is you can turn on requirements. So, for example, I'm going to stay here and I'm going to make another tab. So we'll say duplicate. And if I go back into my statistical account, which I'm going to do at the top level, I can come into here. And one of the things I didn't show you initially is I can come into here and into my statistical accounts, and I can turn on or off some requirements. So for example, for this account, whenever someone enters an amount for this account, I want to make sure that they have a project and a cost code. So this will force the users to enter in the correct information that they need for the reporting. So you could also elect to turn on cost type as well. So that's why this is coming in here. So if I don't put a cost code in, it's going to yell at me. It's not going to let me post that transaction. So back to my entry, and now I can just come into here and say, you know, we're going to project 30 more thousand in costs for this month. Or we could also convert this into a percent. So you could say, you know what, I project we're 86% complete or 0.86. And we could use that in a calculation instead off of budget, estimated cost or actual cost, however you want that calculation to happen. It's all based in the formatting of the report. So in this scenario, we can just say, you know, we're going to have a projected $35,000 more in cost, and this is why. So it will pre-fill the description here in the memo, but you could put your own note or explanation in here, and you can report on that as well. Okay, so you can do that as well in the system. So you would just go through and manually enter those in. And then depending on your routing and who has approvals to post transactions, maybe the user just has permissions to post a draft, and then that could alert somebody else to review that data and post it into the budget for the month. So you can set up those parameters. I'm going to cancel out of here because I'm going to actually show you how we can import those transactions. So instead of entering them in manually, you can also import them. It's just a standard template. I have one over here that we'll use for today, basically my 630 projections for this project, 22022. So you can see here for each of my cost codes, I can put my projections in here. I can get them from another spreadsheet and copy it over. I can format it to pre-populate, whatever you guys want to do. You can also use last month's projection report to get you the Excel sheet that you can use to make your projections. So for example, if I go into general ledger, which is where my projection reports are. So if I go into financial reports here, and you could have these on as a dashboard or a favorite menu for you as well. So I'm going to come down to here. I did set up a report called Project Projected Cost at Completion. Okay. And I can run this and I can date base it. So I can say, you know what, I want to run it. What was it at the end of May? So I could say as of May 31st for which project, and you can run multiple if you want. I have it set up to filter by project, so I can select my Amazon warehouse and I can click OK, and that's going to generate what this was. Here's what the cost to complete forecast was as of 5/31. Okay, and these reports can be formatted any way you want them. I just set one up kind of quickly to get a standard example of how you could do this. You might want to have percent calculations in here. You want to make it red if you're over budget, whatever bells and whistles you want on this design. But what's really nice is you can click Excel, and that's going to download this projection for you to Excel from last month. And you could use that. The project managers could use this Excel function in here then to get you and help you create your projections for the next month. So here's the Excel file, and it comes over very clean. Okay, I can add my formulas in here now. I might want to put a percent field or zero this column out here, you know, because I'm going to key them in manually, whatever you need to do. And you can use this Excel sheet to help you get that import template that we're going to show you next. So these reports can be interactive and you can easily export them into Excel. So I'm going to close that. And so again, just to show you what I'm basically, here's your default template. It's very easy to set up. Once you set up a template, you can have rows that are for your comments only if you don't want to import them. But basically, this is your standard import cost code amount. If I needed the cost type, like labor material, I would have another column for that. I have it over to the right now. But basically, you can put in your projections here, and then we can import this into the system. Okay. So I'm going to close that up. This one's labeled Journal Entries June. I'm going to close that up. And right from the system here, I can go into Statistical Journal Entries. And again, these can be favorited. And I can click Import Transactions. So I can click Import Transactions. And all I have to do is browse to that file. So I have it in my download folders. And there's the June projection. And I would probably have this labeled with a job number on it too if I was just doing one project. But you could import multiple jobs at the same time as well. So I'm just going to open that up and then choose where the results go to, which email. And you click import. And the system's going to go and actually import it. Now, one of the things I did was I set my import up to draft so that when it imports it as a draft, doesn't post yet. I'll have a chance to review it first. I can delete it if I want, or I can edit it. So that imported in successfully. So now if I go to Statistical Journal Entries, and now you notice I have estimated, forecast, and complete, I can view the transactions, and there's my new one. I put my name in the reference, and I have my description, job 22, and it's in draft mode. So I'm gonna go take a look at it. There's those transactions that came in. Cost to complete for this project. Cost code looks good. There's your notes, so you can import in notes as well if you have notes on each line. And looks good. I'm going to go ahead and click post and let that post into the system. Now, what's really nice is you'll notice you also have this duplicate. So if you wanted to do your projections right from this screen, you could click duplicate from last month's. It'll bring it all in, and then you can just go make the changes and change the date for the next month, and then post it in as well. So you can do it that way too. So there's a lot of different ways you can do this, depending on how you want the flow to work. So I'm gonna click post here. And now you'll notice it says posted. So now I know it's part of my numbers. And if I go rerun that report now under financial reports, my projected cost at completion, I can run it as an HTML. Date range it. I can use just today's date, or I can just go to the end of the month and I can pick the project I want. Amazon warehouse, click OK. And now it's showing me as of 6:30, there's my cost to complete. We have some formulas in here that says, okay, for projected cost at complete, take your actual cost plus your cost to complete and give us a cost projected cost at completion, and then run a variance off of your budget. So for 5,000 was my budget. I'm projecting to come in 1,200 under budget. Some people like to show the negatives as under budget, so you can flip that formula depending on how you want to see it on the design. And I have these subtotaling by group cost codes. So for general condition, here's where I'm looking. There's my site work cost codes. I can see I'm over budget here. You know, and then we can have notes on these. I don't have the notes on this design right now, but you could drill down into the notes depending on your format of your report. And then I can just keep going. So for site work, looks like I'm over budget. And when I get down to here, it looks like I made it up a little bit here. And you can view this. So it looks like I'm going to come in just slightly under budget here based on my projections for June. And again, you could Excel, you could print that. You could email that out. You can do all of that in the system. So it's very quick, very easy, not complicated, simple method to do projections in Sage Intacct for construction today. So, you know, last thing I'll do is I'll do that copy real quick. And that's a nice little feature. So if I come into my statistical journals, I want to look at my transactions for June. And I'm going to go take a look and click view. And I want to duplicate that. So I want to duplicate it. And now I'm going to change my posting date to July. And then I would change my description, you know. Yes, and we want to update all my memo fields. Yep. Okay. And then I'm going to come in and just make my changes. So I can say that's 3,500 now. That's, you know, 120. So you kind of get that. You can post it as a draft, run a report on it, and then post it again. So you can do that. But this method is very effective. What's really nice about it is, you know, the ability to report back. You can see a snapshot of what your forecasts were a month ago, 2 months ago, run some statistics on that. Where was this big change? Last month you projected we were going to make money. Now we're in the hole. What happened? You know, and you can focus on that based on that information. So, you know, I hope this was helpful. This is one of many methods to do this type of information in the system. Using statistical counts for forecasting, among other things, is a really great tool in the system. Thank you.